I've said that this was a decluttering session, but I've lied. Hi guys, I'm Adina from Living With Enough, and I make cleaning and decluttering videos documenting my journey into minimalism. This is how we left this room on our last decluttering session after cleaning out a clutter hotspot. If you haven't seen that video yet, I've left a link in the description box below so you can check it out. But first, let's take a quick look at what we are dealing with here. There's nothing much. We will be done with it in about an hour tops, right? Wrong. Because my first day of decluttering went so smooth, as I've tackled only a small area in less than an hour or so, I think it gave me the courage to move on to this project, a big decluttering with no plan in mind. That is why in today's video, I will tell you about the 5 mistakes I've done while decluttering this room, with the hope that I can prevent you from running into the same issues I did. So let's get right to it. My first mistake was not scheduling the decluttering session together with the other people in the house. Imagine this, it was Sunday morning, and not any Sunday morning, it was Valentine's Day. We were expecting to have a relaxing day at home and maybe order a pizza to celebrate. That was the plan until I slowly started to put a few things away and clear the surfaces. It was already lunchtime and I was so caught up in the process that I didn't want to stop. So I've spent Valentine's Day decluttering till it got dark outside instead of spending it with my husband and son. In my defense, we did eat that pizza at dinner after all. But this leads me to the second mistake. Don't forget to eat and drink plenty of water. Because I skipped lunch while cleaning for about 6 or 7 hours, I've started to feel dizzy and anxious. As we all know, decluttering tends to be an overwhelming process anyway, because we are faced with so many decisions and also memories. And let's face it, it's hard to let go of stuff. So putting all this extra pressure on you by not taking care of your body is guaranteed to make things even worse. Also, I forgot to drink water, so please bring a water bottle in the space you are decluttering so it's handy. As we are talking about food, you can see here that I've straightened out our small pantry. This is only a part of our pantry because we keep the most used items in a kitchen cupboard anyway. And I guess this was the easiest part of the decluttering process. Because as the day progressed, I've reached another issue. As I don't live alone but with my husband and a 1-year-old son, everybody has its own stuff. Things went smooth with my son so far as he's not very opinionated about his things, as long as he can keep the TV remote control. But with grown-ups, things can get more tricky. So you can write down this rule in red and underline it, but please, don't declutter other people's stuff. My problem was that the storage I've tackled today was not holding only my stuff. And once I took things out, I've started judging each item from my point of view, of course. I didn't throw anything away. I've just put them on piles like trash, recycle, sell and giveaway, for example. And at the end of the day, when I was all done, I've asked my husband to come and have a look. The discussion ended up with a few compromises as expected, but never skip this step. Also related to other people's stuff, don't forget to let everybody know where you put things after decluttering is over. Each household has its own rules where they keep certain things. Some people keep their medicine in the medicine cabinet, in the bathroom, of course. I keep them on the top of the fridge in the kitchen. If I suddenly decide to move them in the bathroom cabinet, I should at least inform my family about this change. You don't want to get a headache and not be able to find a pill in your own house. I am very guilty of this as I consider myself in charge of organizing the home and I always like to change things around in an attempt to optimize the space. In this example, I've moved around the tools by trying to organize them from 2 cabinets to just 1, so in the future we keep 1 cabinet for the pantry and the kitchen pots and pans, and 1 cabinet for tools. But when I did that, I've disrupted the flow of the house in one way, and we will need to organize them together soon. And moving on with my last mistake. A thing is not decluttered until it gets out of the door. I've said that this was a decluttering session, but I've lied. It is more like an organizing session because things are still in our home, just in another place, waiting for us to take them to the trash, recycle, sell or donate them. In order to get them out the door, there is a lot more work to be done. For example, I've had a similar decluttering session a few months ago when we bought this big closet and we've discussed to get rid of some things, but we've only managed to take care of about half of them. So now I had to spend time and energy to deal with them a second time. So after you decide what is the fate of your stuff, take care of it as soon as possible by putting it away in its proper place or take them to the trash. I'm glad you've stuck around until the end, and as a bonus, I'm about to tell you my biggest decluttering tip. That is, just throw away the box. You hear me right. Up until this video, I didn't realize I have a box hoarding issue. My plan was to keep all the boxes from everything we ever buy in case we want to sell the item and this way we can ask for more money, or to keep the item's warranty. I mean, I have to take things back because they broke only once in my life and it was immediately after I purchased something. That is why I would say to keep the box until the return policy expires, and that is it. Also, I don't remember ever asking a seller if they still had the box for something before buying it from them, so be fine without them. Now here is the result of my 6 hours decluttering marathon. We still need to organize the tools, but we have so much more space and I know where everything is. Here are the things that need to go out the door in the next weeks. A ton of kitchen stuff, baby stuff we've outgrown, books and things we never use anymore. Thank you for watching and I hope you've enjoyed my video and it will help you in your minimalist journey. If it did, don't forget to give it a like.